but I love you.
I love you
until the end.
Liisi LaFontaine, I play Satine in Moulin Rouge the Musical.
I'm Jamie Bogyo, I play Christian in Moulin Rouge the Musical, and we are here today to talk about Moulin Rouge the Musical. it's been a blast. I mean, I've never experienced anything like it. It's been this like incredible high every night. Yeah. I've never seen anything like it in the West End, or I grew up in New York. I never seen anything like it ever. Just like a extravaganza.
It's so immersive.
Yeah.
And I think just having the set kind of be all around you is something that most shows don't have. So I think when you walk in, you're just kind of transported to a different place, and it does not let up from there.
Yeah, no, it's high octane. You know, it's a night out.
My first memory was in high school. And because it came out when we were quite young, so I didn't really watch it until I was a teenager. But I just remember being so over the top and dazzling, and I love Baz's work. Like, Great Gatsby is one of my favorite movies too. So, and the love story, I just remember how dramatic the love story was, and it just reminded me of like these classic Hollywood films where you're just like, everybody calm down, but also you're so invested, you know?
Right. It's operatic and it's source material, but also it's like scope, I think. Yeah, I just remember Ewan McGregor like coming in and I'm like, the hills are alive. And I was like, damn, he can really sing up there. It's high. It's like an A in the movie. He really, I was like, yeah, I remember that.
Because I also did Dreamgirls here, and that was also an equal amount of obsession that people, you know, that comes with these kind of cult classic shows that this represents. And I think you can never make everyone happy, but all you can do is bring yourself to the show and to the role, and I feel like we've created something really beautiful with our cast, and people seem to be loving it. So of course it's daunting, but it's also just like we're just so thankful to be back in a theater and to be doing this. So
I think when it first started auditioning for or coming to London, I actually couldn't get an audition for it because I just graduated from school and I didn't have an agent yet, and then it got pushed because of COVID and I got an agent, and then I was able to sort of swoop in at the end when they were probably desperate and worried, and they said, all right, we'll take him. I really am grateful for that, because it was like a 6-week long kind of extravaganza of just like very, you know, a lot of anxiety, but also, yeah, I didn't really think it was gonna happen, so it was also just like, well, this is a kind of fun. It was like the fifth time I went, and I was like, oh, this might actually be real. And then I think I ran it like 7 times, and then now here we are. Yeah,
mine was very long. I started auditioning in March of 2020, and then everything shut down. So then I started auditioning again February of this past year, and found out in June after we did a chemistry test in New York. So it was like a year and a half long audition process for me. Very long time coming.
Oh God.
It's so easy to work with Jamie. Jamie's like the eternal optimist in the best possible way. Like, I've said this in maybe 1,000 interviews, but he's a golden retriever as a person. Just like the most, just like, hello everybody. Like, just such a breath of fresh air. Everyone in the cast is just obsessed with him. Every time he walks into a room, they're just like, Jamie.
She's laughing, blushing.
I'm not lying.
There is no worse thing working
there's
with
really,
Liisi.
Yeah, there's no worse thing.
We just get on so well. Like, I guess if there's a worse thing, is it because we get on so well sometimes? Like, if something happens on stage, I'll just like feel her laughing like in a moment, because I know that it's something that would like make her laugh off stage. Like, I don't remember what it was. I probably like messed something up, and I was like holding you, and like, and I could just feel you laughing.
Bouncing.
I
would say the worst thing is we share a level for our dressing rooms. Yeah. It's just the two of us.
She's gonna
and
rack
Jamie
on my
lives
now.
To warm up. Jamie warms up for like 7 hours a day, and it's just mum 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 mum.
All right, hers is It's not that much better. But yeah, I'm mumming a lot.
The warm ups will haunt my dreams. But besides that,
other best thing, we have the exact same pre show meal. I mean, we're on.
We do have. We go
both,
to Joe and the
we
juice.
We both taste like tuna tacos. So there's, I don't know if that's a best or a worst thing.
Yeah.
But yeah, we got those mints. Don't worry.
Yeah.
You got a sword. there are parts that I love about watching the show. I guess, like, selfishly, my favorite moment would probably be there's a part in Roxanne where, like, the music changes and everything comes up red, and I'm just, like, downstage bathed in red, like, living my best, like, most jazz. Like, that, I do really enjoy that moment. But, like, getting to watch, you know, the company do Bad Romance at the opening of Act Two always gives me goosebumps. Getting to, like, you know, any of our love songs, but especially Elephant Love Medley, which is so playful and, like, joyous. It just feels like we're dancing on clouds. Mm. And we're not dancing on clouds, but we're dancing on, like, some sort of steam that's coming in. So, you know,
there is
supposed to be clouds. Smoke. Yeah, there's something there, yeah.
And there's stars everywhere.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think to watch the opening is insane. Mm. Like, I'm not in it, so when we were doing tech, I would just sit and watch it, and I would be like, I would pay for this, and I'm in this show. So definitely the opening and the encore are just, like, so spectacular. And then
I don't see any of the encore.
For me, selfishly, Diamonds, because it's just my Beyonce dreams.
I love to watch Diamonds. It's one of my favorite moments. You ever see me dancing to Diamonds in the box or not?
No.
Because I'm really going for it. Like, when you're doing Single Ladies, I'm like, like, I'm loving it, yeah.
I believe it.
I just don't want to be distracting, but keep an eye out for it. You'll see.
Okay.